I don't know how I missed this.
100 days ago, this forest was nothing more than a graveyard. But with time, it evolved through rain and fire.
I haven't seen this one, right?
Watch as empires rise and predators fall. But the real
question
is, who can survive?
Not the spiders, bruh.
On day one, the tank was built from dirt, a log, and a fox skeleton from head to toe.
But yeah, I think they eat that, no? They like decompose it.
It may look barren now, but where there is death, there is life.
Right. The decomposition. I saw that in a Bill Nye one time. Very cool. Very cool.
The first plants began to emerge, and they overtook the landscape.
Ooh, I like that shot.
Both big.
That was such like a good zoom time. It made it feel like that made it feel like I was watching a 3D movie. That's such like a good zoom to like pull out ratio speed.
And to emerge, and they overtook the landscape.
That, I don't know why I like
that.
That's clean.
Big and small, the snails were the earliest signs of life. And spend most of their time eating.
Bro, how are y'all motherfuckers eating that
Everything
shit?
Everything was at peace.
How are people eating that, man?
No,
oh.
This peace wasn't going to last for long.
That's disgusting.
Plants were disappearing at an alarming rate, and not because of the snails. Something else was eating them. Something underground.
Spider.
Earthworm.
Worm.
They were taking over and destroying everything in their path. I needed to control them. I needed a predator. Meet the eastern worm snake. She is a master worm hunter.
Pink.
And hopefully she can keep their population in check. While this war was going on below ground, something magical
mushroom
began to grow above.
Yummy.
Mushrooms. They are one of the fastest growing species on our planet, and snails have emerged to feed.
But they like mushroom? Yeah, they would. They would.
Mushrooms were not the only
that makes sense.
The
that makes so much sense.
Inside, there lies the beginnings of an empire.
This oh damn!
Carpenter ant
oh hold on!
Is
wait a second!
Of young.
She's got an army inbound. The
Each
queen.
Each one of these larva is going to become a loyal worker to serve her empire.
But there's gonna be a war.
The plants had grown dramatically.
I feel like there's gonna be a war,
many
man.
Many forms of life, but could they live together?
This is that an isopod?
For example, had just laid a pile.
Like a roly-poly?
She has to stand watch because other animals
Ooh.
Were out to eat them. Crickets. They were not only eating her eggs, but many of the plants too. Their population was quickly getting out of hand. They didn't have a predator. Until now, here is a male and female.
Why the bugs like all wet? Why do y'all look wet? What's going on? Like I know the slug, that shit's disgusting. But even he look kind of wet. He's shiny.
Have a predator. Until now, here is a male and female jumping spider.
Oh man, I hate these, but I like their front patterns. Honestly, the whole pattern. This thing looking like an Oreo.
Female jumping spider.
And this one, I like that. Well, I don't know. I don't like the white. I did like the orange though.
They make one deadly duo.
That's fire.
After adding them into the tank, they began the hunt. The crickets have incredible eyesight, but the spider's vision is even better.
They can see backwards.
Eyes on the front and back of
yeah.
the head.
They see in every direction. It's cheating. What the?
With only one bite, he is totally paralyzed. It was time to
okay.
enjoy his hard-earned.
Jeez. Right on. Just a normal day.
Now, life around the log did not go unnoticed.
Inside, ants.
The queen's first worker had begun to hatch. The queen helped her emerge from her cocoon until she could stand on her own 6 feet. She was the first of many. By day 50, the tank right was on. Completely overgrown.
Overgrown? Jesus. Oh, get a lawnmower in here. What the heck? Wait, who's a lawnmower?
The plants were choked.
Wait. Whoa. What's that one guy? With the like, he's got scissors for hands. What's that one guy? A centipede. No. Bro, he's like, they use him as a scary movie in the Magic School Bus. Not a centipede. Why am I thinking about a centipede? It's that one thing. It's not a crane. Fuck. It's beside the crane in Kung Fu Panda. With Po. He's got a, mantis. Is it a, no. Well, that is kind of what I was thinking. But now that just sounds stupid. That just sounds stupid. What the fuck?
I need something to eat them. Something big.
Meat. A millipede. Okay. Right.
These large herbivores should eat many of the plants.
Right.
After adding,
I knew that.
They took refuge deep in the undergrowth.
Those are disgusting.
They explored the tank, looking for a
safe place to hide. Well, this just reminds me of like the shit you'd see in the fucking King Kong, what would you call it? The river scene. Whenever they're going down the boat. Are they going down the boat? I always forget that if they're walking or if they're on a boat. Because I think they do both. But there's a part where they run into like a bunch of centipedes and a bunch of grasshoppers that are fucking massive. And also millipedes and whatnot. That shit disgusting.
This one had walked right past a web.
Oh.
A jumping spider.
Ooh, he's setting up. And he's rubbing it down.
This nest was built with one goal in mind.
Pause.
To protect her young. For now, she closes off the door and seals herself in.
That's just disgusting.
Meanwhile, the slug eggs were about to hatch. At this stage, they were completely transparent, and the babies were trying to find a way out.
Aww, ew.
The first baby manages to break free, and soon the rest follow.
Aww, he's got tiny little eyes. Ew. It's so cute, but it's ugly.
And all
oh my
of the
God.
Animals needed to hide. It could only mean one thing. It was about to rain.
They hide from the rain, huh? Oh, where's the guy that likes rain? Who is that guy?
Many of the animals gathered after the storm for a drink. Even the worm snake made a short visit.
Oh, damn. That man's been at war. He's finally back. Oh, pink!
By day
oh, wow.
Flowers began to bloom.
Those are some nice flowers. Those are very nice. Very pretty.
Despite their beauty, not all life was balanced. The jumping spiders were having trouble finding food as the ants were taking over.
Oh, go to war with the ants, man.
Inside their nest, an army was forming.
Bro, fucking jump them.
I needed to stop them. It was time to introduce...
Throw a grenade in there. Bro, if they just threw a grenade in there, that's GG.
And not just any scorpion. These are wood scorpions. They have powerful claws and a venomous sting.
Holy shit, those things look thick. Oh my.
So, it was time
they're
to
so
add them
thick but like small.
I carefully
oh my goodness.
Lowered them into the undergrowth. Most of the scorpions decided to take shelter.
Motherfucker just jumped off backwards.
But this one
no.
wandered into jumping spider territory.
Oh, he's already going to war. Oh.
He has no idea because he is nearly blind.
Nearly.
His only option was to stand completely still.
Hit it. Hit it with a jab. Hit it with a jab. Bro, that is
tasting him to see if he's
bro,
food.
Stab him in the eye. Bro, it's gonna bite.
Begins to walk away, he moves.
Why?
But it looks like he got away with it.
Bro, he almost threw. He's
that
crazy.
Almost cost
what
him
the
his
fuck?
Life.
He's crazy.
And
no.
Soon, day faded to night, and they reemerged.
Ooh, they're glowing. Oh.
They glow under ultraviolet light, so they can recognize one another.
Oh, everything's so fascinatingly
shadows,
gross.
Oh!
What the, fuck
ornate
is that?
Harvestmen.
How?
They scavenge the dark terrain.
That looks like a fucking crab, man. Oh, no.
By day 90,
that's an armored spider.
There was no more rain, and the ground began to dry out.
Look like it doesn't know. What the heck?
I carefully removed every last animal from the tank. But not for the reason you might think.
War.
Because on day 94, a dry thunderstorm was about
a
to
dry?
Begin.
A dry?
A wildfire. It quickly began to spread.
Bro. Huh? He set this shit on fire. What the fuck?
Everything began to burn until every last plant was gone.
Jesus, alright.
Or so I thought.
I mean, with death there is life. And that fucking skull is bopped.
From the ashes sprouted new life. The cycle was going to begin all over again and again and again. Here is another ecosystem I made.
Aww.
And be sure to check it out.
Yeah, I mean, that was cool. Oh, the desert one. Yeah, that one was cool. I know I watched the desert one. I still can't tell you if I've even seen this one, man. But, as usual, Dr. Plants kills it, man. Absolutely fantastic.